Pardon?
Y'all live right here.
No, I mean, so, you working out of the city, or you, because of Oakville East, that you've moved to this facility from wherever, or? Just trying to, as far as the history is concerned.
It's kind of fixed.
Pardon?
It's fixed, so some of us have worked here, some moved here.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, well, thank you all for coming in, and, yeah, I think we're a little, or maybe I don't need it, how's that? That may be too soft, I don't, can everybody hear?
That's about right.
Okay, so, first off, I want to thank Oakville East and Dave for reaching out and asking me to come. I'm hoping that this is a little bit like going to your in-laws and watching their last summer's vacation. But also, I want to thank the Johnson County Historical Society for some pictures and some information. The families of Lindley and Dorr for a couple of pictures here. Crowing County Historical Society, out my fire career, Brainerd Daily Dispatch. Iowa City Press Citizen for some of the photos, and then all the people that have helped me through my career in emergency services, which started in about 1972. So, for those longtime residents in Iowa City that sat on the corner of Lynn and Capitol, and unfortunately, it was torn down in 1961, but the fire station itself was down here at Oakville, and I was born and raised in Iowa City in 1957, took a field trip in first grade to the fire station, and I didn't get to meet these guys. They were long before my time, but this was in October of 1925, and this was the end of the horse-drawn era for Iowa City. They had become mechanized. According to the Historical Society, I believe this vehicle over here was the chief's vehicle, and the department had expanded to 7 full-time, 24/7 firefighters, and the rest were volunteers. In 1842, when the Iowa City Fire Department was first established, it was all volunteer firefighters. And if I base it off of what Brainerd was like back in a similar era, a lot of those were kind of, they were almost like baseball teams. Everybody had their own uniform, everybody was trying to outdo the other guys, you know, they needed better buckets, taller ladders, yeah, those sort of things. Whoops. This is another shot of the fire station. And so the senior center sits across the street over here. That was the post office when I was growing up as a kid. And that was also the place where Selective Service was at and where I was given a bus ride to Camp Dodge to go and take my physical. But this is